We will start with a series of lectures to study AWT. In this lecture, we'll study few basics of AWT and the concept of applets. Let's first learn what is AWT. It is a set of APIs used for creating GUIs. They are basically a set of classes available in a package called as java.awt, and these classes will help you to create graphical user interfaces. Here you see the class hierarchy that is available in java.awt package. We all know that at the top of inheritance hierarchy in Java, there is a class called as object. From the object class, there is a class that derives, which is called as component. From the component class, there are various other classes that are deriving, like button, label, checkbox, and many others. These classes help us to create various entities in a GUI. There is also a class called as container that derives from the component class. And from the container class, there are various other subclasses that you see here: window, panel, applet, dialog, frame, and so on. Subsequently, we will learn how to create and use them and what each of these mean. Let's learn some basic terminologies that we are going to use in creating GUIs using AWT. Let's first understand what is a component. A component is a GUI entity that allows user to interact with the application in various ways. For example, we will learn how to create a push button, how to create a window, and use them. Next, we will learn what a container is. A container is that component which contains other components. For example, window is a component, but window can contain a push button. Thus, window is a container component. Similarly, frame, applet, etc. are also containers. In a GUI, we need to position the components and place them at proper places. This is done with the help of a layout manager. Thus, a layout manager is that part of a GUI which positions components within a container. We summarized this whole thing as: the appearance in a GUI is determined by a combination of the components and the layout manager that is used to position them. We understand the meaning of this statement with the help of this diagram. Here, this is a GUI which is consisting of a window. Okay. This window is enclosing various components. So here you see there is a label. This is a text field. Here also you see a label and a text field. This component here is called as a combo box. Here you see certain check boxes. There is radio button. And there are two push buttons. So there is a window that is containing many components like text fields, check boxes, and buttons. You will also observe that these components have a particular arrangement. This arrangement is due to a layout manager. So we will learn how to create the components. We will learn how to create a container. We will learn how to use a layout manager to put the components within a container. Let's start with our first container component called as an applet. Applets are small Java programs that are used in internet computing. Applets can be transported over the internet from one computer to another. Applets are Java programs at a very basic level, but for executing them, we would require a special application called as an applet viewer, or we would require a web browser that supports Java. Applets are used for performing various arithmetic operations. They can be used for displaying some graphics as part of a web page. They can be used for playing sounds, accepting user input, creating animation, or playing interactive games. So here you see our first applet program. The name of the program is hellojava.java. There are two classes that you see at the top which are imported. The first one is a graphics class and the second one is an applet class. Graphics class helps us to do some drawing. Graphics class is available in java.awt package. And applet class is available in java.applet class. We write the class as a public class. That's a requirement for an applet. And this class has to extend the applet class. Within this class, you will see there is one method that is written, a paint method. This method derives from the applet class. This method has to be written like this. It has to be public, should not be returning anything. The name of the method is paint and must be taking a parameter, which is an object of graphics class. Within the method, you see that there is a method called as drawString, which is called here. DrawString is a method of graphics class that will help us to write some string in a window or in an applet. So here the string that we are drawing is welcome to the world of graphics, and this string will be drawn at a location 50, 50, where 50 is the x coordinate and this 50 is the y coordinate. Once such a program is written, you will see here that there is no main method. So once you write the program and save the program, we need to create one HTML file for executing an applet. So you see here an HTML file created. The name of the HTML file is hellojava.html. You'll see usual tags of an HTML file. What is important here is this applet tag. So we write applet code equal to, and here you will write the name of the class file that will get generated when you compile hellojava.java. You will use two arguments here. One is height, another is width, for setting the height and the width of the applet. This applet tag has to be closed. So we use an applet tag. There are three attributes that we use. First is the code. To code, we will give the name of the class file corresponding to the Java file that we have written. Second attribute is the height, and third attribute is the width. Once such an HTML file is written, here you will see how to execute this. So we compile first hellojava.java. This is the Java code that is containing the applet program. After that, this will result in creating hellojava.class. After that, we use applet viewer command, and to applet viewer we are going to give hellojava.html. So there are two files that you would have to create. One is .java file, another is .html file. .java file you will compile, .html file you will give as an argument to applet viewer. When we do that, this is the output that you are going to see. So here there is a window that opens, which we call as the applet. At the bottom you will see a message, applet started, and this is the exact string that we were printing, welcome to the world of graphics. Here you will see an image, which is an icon. Here you will see the title, which is telling you which file is getting executed. Now there is a shortcut that we can use. Rather than creating two different files, one is .java, another is .html, you can create a single file with .java extension, and in the single file you can write Java code as well as the HTML code. Only care you have to take is put the HTML code within comments. Once this is done, then for execution you will say Java C hello java.java. That will generate hello java.class, and to applet viewer also you are going to give the same .java file. The execution of this program and the output of the program remains the same. So what we have done exactly is that here when I compile this program by using Java C, Java C ignores the commented part and generates a file called as hello java.class. After that, when I give this file to Applet Viewer, Applet Viewer ignores everything other than the HTML part, and thus it has nothing to do with the Java code that you have written or the comments that we have put in. It only looks at the HTML code and executes hello java.class. The output is going to remain the same.